When you are measuring odor, you'll typically be using a technique called dynamic olfactometry. Now, in some cases, you can go and specifically measure the concentration of one odor compound, usually something like hydrogen sulfide or ammonia. That's a really, really strong and important one. But if you're trying to characterize all these very many odor compounds at once, it is much more effective and accounts for some of our subjective differences in the way we smell things by using dynamic olfactometry. So a couple definitions to understand before we explain this more. An odor detection threshold is the physical concentration of a substance at which 50% of people can detect it. So it's right on that threshold. I'm not sure yes or no, is it there? If you go above the odor detection threshold, then you'll be saying, yeah, I can definitely smell something. If you go below, then you're saying, I don't think I smell anything. And then as you go much, much higher or much, much lower, the smell will just get stronger and stronger and stronger, or less and less detectable the other way. And odor detection threshold would be in your normal concentration units for an air contaminant, like ppms or milligrams per cubic meter and things like that. Another way to measure that is with a dimensionless odor unit. So one odor unit is equal to the concentration in ppms or whatever unit at the odor detection threshold. So for example, hydrogen sulfide, our noses are really, really sensitive to. We can detect it at something like 10 parts per billion. So 10 parts per billion would be the odor detection threshold. And one odor unit for hydrogen sulfide would coincide with that 10 parts per billion. Typically, ECAs require one odor unit at the point of impingement. So if I'm standing right at the gate of your facility and looking over the fence, I'll be just on the fence about deciding, can I smell your facility or not? That's where you're legislated to be. And that's whether you're a really stinky facility, like a landfill or a composter or a rendering plant, or you're a really pleasant smelling facility like a chocolate factory or a cookie factory or something like that. You really aren't supposed to let that come off site because that is defined by the EPA as a contaminant. Now, how dynamic olfactometry works is you assemble a panel of people, and they're all pre-screened to be about average smellers, and you'll expose them to different concentrations of samples that are taken on site. So on site, you'll go with a sampling pump and a sample bag, and you'll actually just pump air into a bag and bring it back to the lab. When you go to use the olfactometer, and I've done this, you spend a whole day just smelling things and pressing buttons. Very fascinating. So you go up to the machine and it will feed you a concentration of that sample plus a bunch of air it's diluted with. So it will start at a really low concentration. So in my figure here, we'll be starting over here a high number of dilutions. And normally you can't smell anything. It's supposed to start below the odor detection threshold. And you'll be asked, yes or no, can you smell it? And then you press a button for yes or no, and then you get it in next dilution. So you'll work into less and less dilutions and more closer to the raw sample. And at a certain point, you'll stop saying, no, I can't smell it, and yes, I can smell it. And that's when you've crossed this odor detection threshold, this one odor unit line. And it'll be at a different number of dilutions for different people. Again, the odor panel is supposed to be all average smellers, so it's around the same place, but it'll be slightly different. Where you start saying, no, I can't smell it, and yes, I can smell it, that number of dilutions will let the scientist running the test correlate the actual concentration with the odor ability of the average person. And that will let you do things like confirm that your sample is taken, if it was taken at your POI, that it's below your requirement, usually one odor unit, or it could be used, you know, if you're closer to an odor generator to do some modeling of how that might spread downstream, different things like that.